The differences between organic and conventional are they're pretty stark.
Pesticides are all over conventional produce, whereas using a synthetic pesticides is not allowed in organic production.
Before I even started, I read a little book by Rachel Carson, Silent Spring, and it had a profound effect on me. I'd been working for farmers that used chemicals, and it was pretty easy for me to see and understand what the word poison meant. So I just knew from the get-go that I wanted to farm without the use of harsh chemicals, and I did that a long time ago. We use a more natural-based approach. You know, we use biologicals and insects.
We don't use anything synthetic.
Whenever there's a harsh chemical applied to the plant and soil, you're not just, you know, taking care of what is perceived as a pest. You're also just killing everything.
Here at Full Circle Farms, the name really indicates how we try to run the farm.
We like to think about it as a whole system approach, and that means making sure the soil's healthy from the start, and then making sure the plants are healthy.
We're able to do a better job protecting pollinators, protecting soil, microbial health. We're also using a lot of rotational crops, such as alfalfa, which is one of the main ones we use to build up nitrogen and organic matter in the soil.
There's several ways that you can naturally nourish the soil. The first is with compost.
Everything that we have, all the waste in the farm, goes back into the soil.
You start with the foundation of the soil, and then you move into the plant diversity. It's kind of like an immune system, really. It becomes more, the system becomes able to protect itself.
I think we should start with the effect on human bodies. There's a lot of studies looking at the effects of exposure to pesticides when babies are in utero, so before they've been born. And studies following these children for 7 years have found that pesticide exposure when in the womb can decrease children's IQ by anywhere from 5 to 7 points. You can see that the kids who have really high pesticide levels in their bodies are much more likely to have ADD and ADHD. There's a number of pesticides that are used. 60 different pesticides are used in strawberry production alone. Pesticides are definitely something that, you know, people think about they're eating when they eat their food. What they don't realize is that by having this environmental contamination with pesticides, we're breathing them in when they're in the air, we're drinking them when they're in our drinking water. So it's not just through the food chain that we're being exposed, it's through our environment as well. When you apply a pesticide to a plant, you're essentially removing that plant's impetus to need to make any sorts of, if its own insecticides or its own phytochemicals to protect itself from other pests. And it turns out those things that the plants makes are polyphenols and antioxidants that are actually really nutritious and really important for our health. You buy an organic tomato, for example, you're buying a tomato that's going to have 30% more vitamin C, 20% more lycopene. So yeah, you are paying a little bit more, but you're getting a more nutritious product. One thing that I absolutely know is that you can always trust the organic label. It is the highest standard out there. It is the only one that the government really polices and always making sure that they're adapting to what consumers expect organics to be.
We really appreciate Natural Grocers' commitment to 100% organic produce. I think they're setting a standard in the grocery industry that other people are going to be catching up to for quite a while.
We really strongly feel that this is what should be being fed to our families and the way that the land should be managed.
In the end, you can see a better livelihood for yourself and your family by choosing to go and grow things organically.